All right, so we're on with Lord Jelly. Let's go ahead and pull up the KD. We'll pop up. Yeah, I think his profile's private. So wherever we get next, we'll try it again. All right, so Lord Jelly. Got some plates, got some armor going. I don't know what he landed on, but he's got a satchel, kill streaks. I don't know. Damn. Wow.
Focus.
Wow. Wow. Bro, you came out with a fully automatic weapon and he just did you in with 3 shots. Let's go, Brandon. Let's go, Brandon. Now he feeling himself. Wow, bro is a menace. You're not ghosted, I mean. Everything but the kitchen sink, right? We got him with the grenade. Damn, I'm like, did you not see him? So we saw him, like when he hit that corner, we saw him jump out even after his plate broke. I think the guy that we just watched die was on console because his FOV might have been low. Because there's no way we saw him, but he didn't. The only explanation is a low FOV or simply playing on console. I just spitballing. Not saying that's a bad thing or anything, but it's just one of those things like that. That console players have been asking for, and it's like games like Battlefield have FOV on console. Like Call of Duty is just so far behind. What's his name? I don't know how you say his name. Repsicuff. So he sit on the 1.49 KD, 1967 kills, and the average time per life is 6 minutes and 13 seconds. So average player. Let's see how he gets his kills. Let's see how he does his magic. You're on console. Yeah, console looks cool. Don't take my comments as talking down on console. That's where I came from. You know, that's what I spent over 20 years playing on. So it's just one of those things, especially in 2022, seeing how powerful these consoles are now. An FOV slider on console is like why can't you give us that? It's like listening to the community. That's a legacy feature. I saw that tweet somewhere I seen it on Reddit or somewhere, and it's like ever since I saw that. That comment resonates in my mind, like just listening to the fans and giving them what they want versus giving them what you want them to want or what you think they want. It's like listening to the community is just it's a feature that we lost when the Xbox 360 and PS3s phased out. Ever since the Xbox One and PS4 era began, it's like we've been getting more and more of what we don't want every year. Not just Call of Duty either. It's like, I mean, you could probably name any major AAA game, especially ones that come out every year from the last edition that came out on 360 PS3 up until now. I bet you they're in a worse place than what they were before. 2K, Madden, like every EA game, Call of Duty, Battlefield, even Halo. People like to say Halo is the best thing going right now. And that's only because multiplayer is actually a little fun. But to me, I don't even really care for Halo like that, like the multiplayer. For me, it's missing a lot. The game as a whole is missing a lot. Co-op campaign is missing Forge. Game like a lot of game modes in multiplayer, like team SWAT, team snipers, doubles, like all the different game modes. Like when the game came out, it was just big team action and I think fours or something. It's like, bro, like what happened to SWAT? Like that's all I ever played on Halo 3 was SWAT. And he just shredded him with the incendiary round MP40. Bianca, we were just talking about it. MP40 incendiary rounds, that's the meta. But he's about to die. Oh shit, where is he? Probably on your left. I feel like on your left. Yep. On your left side somewhere. Yep. You probably got him. Go to work. But yeah, Halo's missing a lot. Like a lot of games are just bad. A lot of games are bad, bro. It's just a bad time in gaming. And it's like not with just one franchise or one game. It's like with different games, different franchises, different. Damn. God damn. 7:30 just knocked your head off, my boy. 7:30, nice reticle. Wow. Not even using any Vanguard guns. I like that. Hockey, you know. Bro, he's at 20. Is he hacking? Bro, sitting on 20 kills. Rank 34, you got Damascus. Do we have a hacker on stream? 20 kills, bro. You got it. And you just hit. You getting these crazy ass kills? We might have a hacker, ladies and gentlemen. Let's see. You got 7 spectators, so he might be a hacker. With this many spectators, somebody else got to think the same thing I'm thinking. It's like out of all these times I spectate in Warzone, I finally get a hacker. I hope this is a hacker because this is gold. Yep, he's definitely hacking. You know where somebody is, bro. Yes, sir, we got a hacker, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, sir, we got one live on stream. Let's get to it. Let's watch the rest. We got 17 players left, so we are going to witness a massacre unfold. This is what's wrong with Call of Duty. This right here is why I don't play Vanguard. Or not Vanguard, I'm sorry. This is why I don't play Warzone. We have a hacker, ladies and gentlemen. Look at this bullshit. Look at this bullshit. I knew something was off. Like, bro, you were ranked 34. You got a sniper with the Damascus, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's pretty odd, my boy. That's pretty weird. I'm not gonna lie to you. Come on, bro, you got hacks. You should not be missing shots. You know what I'm saying? That's crazy. Just please duck. Please duck. Oh my god. Please just duck. I wish you could communicate to the rest of the lobby that there's a hacker in here. So the people that are alive just know. Like, I wish that was a something you could do. Just text chat. At least be able to use text chat in Warzone. For shit like this, so you can let the rest of the lobby know that somebody in here is hacking. Like, I feel like everybody else in the lobby should be in the loop. You know what I'm saying? You got using the biggest troll in all of horror. Man. Man. So, yep, know somebody else is in there. Definitely know somebody else is in that building. Holy shit. Holy shit, holy shit. I thought that was about to happen. The way he's just snapping, this is how I play. Without the hacks, you know what I'm saying? Not to be cocky or whatever, but it's just calling it how I see it. That's all. But I think we've got ourselves another video that we'll be uploading in a few days. 88 kills for solo? Or is that like duos, trios, squads? Like, what is that? That can't be for solo. Like, and if that's solo by a 7-year-old, yo, that 7-year-old is hooked on G Fuel. I'm telling you, G Fuel is crack for gamers. That shit is legalized crack. I've heard so many streamers and content creators be like, I've been up for hours on G Fuel. My boy, that is crack. Like, bro, you've been up since 3 a.m. My boy, you're full on cocaine. Jesus. Just through the floor, bro? Like, how? Does Black Ops guns have FMJ? I can't remember how do you get bullet penetration on Cold War. Because I know FMJ wasn't like a perk or anything. My 7-year-old, 88 kills, bro. I have to watch that. I might watch that on stream just so we can see that. 88 kills, bro, better go pro. If you drop 88 kills for no reason, I'm gonna be upset. You better be a professional. I need you on Optic, I need you on Phase, something. And if they don't give him a offer, a deal or something, they dumb too. If I'm the leader of a pro Call of Duty team and I just found out a 7-year-old dropped 88 kills in a solo Warzone game, no hacks, bro, I'm treating you like Bronny James and I'm watching you until you're like, bro, I'm gonna give you a deal when you're ready. That young brother is cash money, dollar signs. Oh man, just keep driving. No, don't come in. Don't come in. Don't come in. No. No way, bro. That's like through 3 walls. He shot him through an area of a building that you can't even go in. So I don't even know how you shooting through that, then through the exterior of the building, and getting him. These new hacks is different. Yeah, that's too thick. That's too thick. That wall is too thick, my boy. Nah, somebody's coming back. Somebody's coming back. I know you hear him. Run! No, don't tell me you dropped. And you got dropped. Oh my god. FaZe is smart. FaZe is smart. They usually hop on people quickly. Like, quickly. that's something I do give FaZe a lot of credit for. They get on, they sign people so fast. That's on the come up. Even though they, from what I've heard, FaZe can be, they can be kind of scandalous with some of the stuff they promote. I have heard bad things about FaZe in the last, you know, year or so. They promote scams and, you know, scam cryptocurrencies. And don't get me wrong, I'm into cryptos myself, but I try not to promote them too much. I used to promote them on my social media, but nah. But nah. I don't like promoting that shit. If you interested, I'll tell you what I know. I don't know so much, but, you know, mostly because, you know, people can just lose their money with that shit. So I don't promote it. I don't advise it. Just be smart with your money. And in general, when it comes to gambling or investing, this is just a general tip for me. Just invest what you're willing to lose. You know what I'm saying? Like, don't invest money that you're going to be sick if it's gone. Or if you lose a majority of that money that you put up. Like, put up money that you like, if I lose this, man, I'll still be able to eat tonight. You know, I'll still be able to eat tomorrow. I'll still be able to pay my bills on the first this month. Or next month, or the 15th this month, whatever the case might be. You know, celebrities and shit, they look at cryptos and NFTs and all these shits as easy get rich quick schemes. Like, just doing these pump and dumps, they'll promote shit, get people to invest so the price go up, their money goes up, and they pull all their shit out. And then they leave the little man's like us aching in our wallets. But again, I don't try to promote shit like that, you know. I think it's something cool to invest in, don't get me wrong, but I'm all about doing y'all due diligence, put up what you're willing to lose. And just again, do your due diligence. Do your research. Like, really do your research. Utility of shit. Who's backing this shit. You know, if you saw somebody promote it, look at their track record. The shit that they promoted in the past. Is it trustworthy? You know what I'm saying? Back to the game. I've been rambling about cryptos and, you know, scams and all that. But he's still trucking. 31 kills. He's got 10 good old spectators. 5 players left. He's sitting on 30,000 guala. No, some money is right here. It's like, if I'm a hacker, I just would do things so differently. I would make it so there's no chance in hell I'm dying. The plays I make, the pushes I go for, like, I'm making it so there's no way in hell you're gonna kill me. Just waiting for him to clean these kills up, honestly, like, I don't know what's stopping. Boy, look at the tracking. Like, you can tell the other guy's going crouch, going in the prone, back and forth. Like, I dropped 21 and died by an LMG. See, that would have been my last game that day. The day I dropped 21 and died in general, that's the last game I play. All right, so sitting on 33 kills, it's down to him and the last guy, and it is over. Man, we got ourselves a hacker on stream. That's great.
7:30.
Good game.
Man, must
fucking
suck that.
Yo, 7:30. I got your IP address, you faggot.
Oh, man. Joy, buddy. Go get a real job. Go get a real job, 7:30. Quit spending your fucking welfare money on
cheats.
It's
not our fault that your fucking father raped you your whole fucking life,
7:30. Dude, what a faggot, bitch. Piece of shit.
You're a piece of shit. Okay, dude. I wish I could hunt you down and rip your fucking throat out.
Alright, his daddy touched him. It's okay. He doesn't know better.
Oh, I know.